Bishop today, St. Peter Damian, Bishop and Doctor of the Church, and we have a bunch of history on him.
We do, and Pope Benedict XVI and his audiences took some of these great figures, these great saints, and did wonderful expositions of their lives and their relevance to the modern world. Pope Benedict writes, Peter Damian, he distinguished himself in the widest range of literary forms, from letters to sermons, from hagiographies to prayers, from poems to epigrams. His sensitivity to beauty led him to poetic contemplation of the world. Peter Damian conceived of the universe as a never-ending parable and a sequence of symbols on which to base the interpretation of inner life and divine and supernatural reality. Monsignor, it's interesting. Pope Benedict described so well that in so many cases in the lives of the saints, their interior life, they have their experience of interior life and this mystical life with God and the indwelling of the Trinity and their missionary charism and spirit at their time in history. But often that experience of prayer gets translated through a literary talent, a gift for the very different genres of literature, whether it's hagiography, letters, poems, tributes, all the different genres. And Peter Damian was one of those literary saints who leaves us a great patrimony of things to reflect on in terms of our own experience of God and life.
And I love that he also went to Milan, which in a lot of ways was like an ancient New York City. And it needed direction, it needed the church, it needed faith. And that's where he focused a piece of his ministry.
Exactly. That Milanese church is so powerful. The legacy of St. Ambrose, the great Milanese liturgy that is so important there. The great Pius XI was from Milan. He was a librarian of the great treasures of Milan. So we go to this wonderful saint, and St. Peter Damian, pray for us.
Pray for us.